Hey everybody, what's up? It's your girl Different and welcome to Different's World YouTube channel. I hope you all out there are having a wonderful day like your girl. And if not, you better be manifesting, planning, and preparing for a better one because it's surely coming to you all for show. If this is your first time to my YouTube channel, welcome you guys. Happy to have you. My name is Different. I'm an author, motivational speaker, and CEO of my own business, Third Eye Entertainment, LLC, a business that strives to bring social awareness to society through our products and services in which we educate, inspire, and entertain all at once. So again, if this is your first time to my channel, welcome. Again, be sure to hit that subscribe channel before you leave. If this is your first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth, 11th, 12th, whatever time back, welcome back to the Different World. Happy to have you guys. Today is Monday, the first week of February, first Monday of February, and so I want to start this Monday off right. It's Black History Month, this week we're going to be celebrating, motivating, and encouraging, you know, the culture of people that's of the culture, the Black culture, you know, my people. And so with this one, it being Monday, you know, on Mondays we do our motivational content. And so for this one, it's going to be no different. However, it's going to be tailored towards people of the culture, of the Black culture, if you will, and motivating and encouraging you guys to keep going, keep persevering, keep being Black and being proud of that. Definitely. And being proud of who you are, where you come from, and knowing where you're going. Getting right into it, you guys. Often we start off, or most of the time, they start off celebrating Black History Month about bringing up our history and a lot of people that were involved in the Black Civil Rights Movement, such as, you know, Martin Luther King, Malcolm X, Rosa Parks, you know, a lot of people in, you know, history, Black history, that have done a lot of great things for us, such as, you know, Muhammad Ali, Mahalia Jackson, Aretha Franklin. The list goes on and on and on. You know, it's so much Black excellency, you know, that's been put out into the world, you know, to whence, you know, we've done so much for society to the point we basically are, you know, the society we created this, you know, this all started behind, you know, what we started. And so I'm so happy and proud to be a Black woman and be a part of the Black culture. Although I do have other races in my family, including white and, you know, Hispanic and Native American, for the majority, I am a Black woman. People see me, they see me as a Black woman. When I look in the mirror, that's what I see, a Black woman. And so that's what I claim myself to be, as a Black woman. And so that being said, you know, as far as the motivational part of it and what drives you and for those that what motivates you and gets you up and gets you going, you know, those that are part of the culture. And again, it's not just about Black people, but this is for Black History Month, you guys. So even if you're not Black, this is still, you know, dedicated to you and encouraging you guys to, you know, go for yours and persevere and to also be proud of who you are and where you come from and making sure, you know, you don't forget so you know where you're going. So it's not just about Black people, but again, this is dedicated to my people, you know, letting you guys know that I'm here with you guys and I stand with you guys. So with that being said, again, ever, you know, you guys are going out there for your dreams. You got, you know, small businesses, you know, acting, singing, dancing, here, you know, a lot of up and coming rappers, you know, doing their thing, you know, keep going, Black people, Black kings, Black queens, you know, it's your God-given right to go for yours and get everything that you got coming to you, what you feel that you are deserving for. You got to manifest, plan, and prepare for it, and surely it will come to you guys. But in order to do that, you guys, you got to get up, get out, get something, and go for it. Shake off the shackles and all the dead weight that, you know, people have pressed on you, oppressors have given us. And, you know, never let it stop you, hold you back. You know, there's so many of us now that are breaking the chains and the mental bondage and, you know, the psychological warfare that we've been stuck in for centuries. It's so many of us that are doing our part and coming together in unity and helping one another. And so I love to see, you know, our community thrive, and any chance I get to uplift and push those further and encourage them, you know, to go higher, I do it. And especially when it comes to advocating for mental health awareness in the Black community. As a matter of fact, I think tomorrow for the Social Awareness Blog, I'm going to dedicate that to, you know, speaking on mental Black health awareness. So be sure to tune in for tomorrow's vlog. Also, you guys, before we go any further, just to remind you guys, as far as, you know, when it comes to being proud of who you are, it was first taught by us by self-love and self-care and self-pride by the Godfather. So one of history, the one and only, you know, James Brown. And so he is the one who said it first, to say it loud, to say it proud. I'm black and I'm proud. And so with that being said, you guys, as far as, you know, the motivational concept, let's check out this dope video with James Brown's Say It Loud music in the background playing. When we come back on, I'll show you guys a little bit more what's going on in Difference World, and definitely, you know, do a mental health check with you guys. So here it is. Check it out. Welcome back. I hope you guys enjoyed watching that dope video, a collage of pictures with James Brown, Say It Loud music in the background playing. So definitely shout out to James Brown. May he rest in peace. Man, his music still lives on. I love listening to James Brown, man. It's just something about it. When you put on his music, it speaks black pride and being proud of who he was in that time. And watching even the movie Get On Up with Chadwick Boseman, may he rest in peace. How he bodied James Brown, you know, and lived his story and brought it to life, excuse me. It just tells you, you know, how much and how proud he was to be a black man and do for the black culture. And so he did a job well done. And, you know, his music lives on forever. And that song, you know, Say It Loud, it just rings, you know, true to who we are in the black culture. And it taught us so much of who we are and to be proud of who we are back in the day. Still, some people, you know, don't like the color of their skin, especially if it's too dark. But I say, you know, no matter, you know, like as they say, the darker berry gets me the juice. So, you know, you got tar skin, love that tar skin, man. You know, be proud of it, because there's no other like it. And other than that, you guys, be sure if you like this video and you're part of the community, proud of it, Black and You Proud. Definitely show me by hitting that subscribe, liking, sharing, and commenting on my YouTube channel. I do appreciate all the love and support that I am getting, you guys. It's been amazing. I just did an interview with Hello Black Man Podcast. A big shout out to Jay for having me. Tomorrow I have another interview, you guys. I've been busy with these interviews back to back to back. And so I'm a little behind on dropping content, but nonetheless, I'm going to keep dropping it when I can. And so just stay tuned and hit that notification button, you guys, as well. So when you get those notifications, or you come to a different world and you come to learn, yeah. Also, don't forget, go to my website, differenceworld.net, and you can check out all my other social media handles, including Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, as well as my TikTok, and again, my YouTube channel, of course, and as well as my book, What If a Controversial Paradigm Shift? I don't know where it's going to show up, but it's probably here on this side because I got it flipped. But you can go to my website, differenceworld.net, and get your copy of What If a Controversial Paradigm Shift? Again, a book that's written to encourage and inform thought-provoking conversations about injustice and systemic racism in America. And I've done this through provocative and graphic illustrations. And so again, be advised that it is intended for a mature audience. So if you can't take this type of heat, still come on to the kitchen. Why? Because that's the point of this book, is to have those conversations that's uncomfortable. People like to sweep under the rug. It's the point to, you know, come to the round table, have these conversations, hash it out, take some accountability, acknowledge, and then promote and create systemic change. It's not just about racism or pissing people off. It's about unity and coming together and planting seeds for the next generation. That's more so what it's about. So definitely go to my website, differenceworld.net, and get your copy right now. Yeah? All right, you guys. Moving this gravy train right along. Before we get out of here, I've already said, don't forget, tomorrow is Tuesday, so I'll be dropping the social awareness content on Black health, mental wellness, and so definitely check out that, and be sure to come back and check your girl out with that. Also, before we leave, mental health check, you know, that's number one on the list, even though it's the last thing we do, that's a top priority. And so, with that being said, anybody out there that's listening and watching, please know, I don't care if black, white, yellow, brown, purple, blue, green, whatever you are, know that it is okay to not be okay, but never ever sit there and not be okay. If you're going through any type of mental health, any mental anguish, such as bullying, feeling suicidal, anxiety, whatever the case may be, depression, it is okay to not be okay, but don't ever sit there and not be okay, man. Go get help, go talk with somebody. If you need to get on some type of psychological medicine, do so. Talking with a family member, the therapist, friends, cutting people off who mean you well, mending broken bridges, hitting that gym up. Whatever it is that you have to do, man, do it. Whatever it takes to keep you from going off the deep end, do it. Possibly not taking anybody with you. If you know or need these resources, please feel free to share it. The crisis hotline number is 1-800-273-8255, or you can text or call 988 or text 741-741. For those that would prefer to go online, you can visit mentalhealthishelp.us or 988lifeline.org for those that are outside of the U.S. and need any type of mental resources for their countries. You can check out encounseling.com. Again, that's spelled encounseling.com. And again, don't forget to do your own homework. Even though I'm providing you guys with these resources, remember, you are the captain of your own ship. You decide where to navigate it. So you are in control. And remember, it's okay to not be okay, but never, ever, ever sit there and not be okay, because you are not alone and this too shall pass. Yeah? All right, you guys. So with that being said, we're going to move right along and close out of this vlog. I definitely, again, appreciate all the love and support that I am getting. Be sure, please hit that subscribe button. Come on back to my channel. Share it with others and tell the others about it. Definitely go to my website, differenceworld.net, and get your copy of my book, What If? A Controversial Paradigm Shift. Oh, and also, don't forget, you guys, I'm also available for motivational speaking events. If you want me to be a part of any grassroots conversations, you can go to my website, differenceworld.net, and you can book me there. I am free of charge as of now, but pretty soon that's all about to change. And so, in closeout, you guys, thank you guys so much. Don't forget, whatever it is in life that you are believing that you're destined for, you got to manifest, plan, and prepare for it, and then it will surely come to you all. Difference World, come and learn. Peace.
What if?
What if in 1619 Africans started dealing in slave trading?
The tables were turned around.
What if they kidnapped millions of Englishmen, women, and children from their homeland and brought them to America on a slave ship?
What if A Controversial Paradigm Shift is a book written to inform and encourage consistent, thought-provoking conversations about injustice and systematic racism in America through graphic but provocative illustrations? What if provides a different perspective by detailing controversial deaths and events as four categorized paradigm shifts: historical, political, precedent, and hypothetical? What if A Controversial Paradigm Shift by author Different? Go to differenceworld.net.